What's up everyone, Simply here and today we are gonna do a simple video, finally. Most of the time those videos take a lot of time to edit and stuff, but I hope you're still having fun with PokéRogue. I have been having fun, having some issues with the servers lately, but overall, pretty good experience I would say. I hope you got a good shiny event as well. I'm gonna do a video about the shiny event after this one, but let's get into this one. So today we are gonna talk about links that you might want to use for your PokéRogue experience. There is a couple of them that are pretty nice to use just for Pokémon overall, but there is some links for PokéRogue specifically, and I'm gonna talk about this today. So let's start with the first link. It is the link to the Discord. So the Discord is pretty important. Of course, this is the first link because I would say this is the less important one, mainly because there is a lot of people talking about a lot of things, I would say. There is a lot of strats that work and don't work. It depends. You have to know a bit about Pokémon to filter the wrong information. You know what I mean? But there is still some information, some strats left and right. This is going to be the Discord. So for the Discord, we're going to go into the community. You have Discord here. You can access it very easily. And when you are on the Discord, so this is where what you have here. I'm going to talk about the Discord and all the resources about Discord that are available on Discord, sorry. So you have all the links for Endless. So there is a couple of classic Endless guides, but you have some okay guides in the Discord. I guess some of them are going to be linked. So there is a speedrun. There is a Batcrow. So this is a presentation. I'm going to show you what it is. And you have some information about useful moves. But let me talk about this one. I'm going to group this into Discord links because I'm not going to link all the Google Docs. And I have a Google Doc coming as well pretty soon with all those information. So about Endless, Fusions, Classic tier list. There is going to be a lot of things on the doc, but I will let you know for that. So let's talk about those guides here. All right, so we have all the links here. As you can see, we have the beginner guide, which is very, very beginner. There is a lot of information in it. So what is Endless? How does it work? What are tokens? The mechanics of it? How does it work? Some mechanics about the splicing and the fusion, which is very important in Endless. You have some examples here, team building, very, very, very broad, I would say. What carry, checklist, how to start your run, what to check for, mid game. Some of the mech as well that are actually explained here in this Google Doc here. So this is all the useful moves for the current meta. So this may change in the future. So I'm not gonna stay too much on it. There is a lot of different information. You have guides to all of those beginner guides. So the one from C4V and Batcrow. And you have the two speedrun. And just a lot of information on all the moves, sorry, that are used. So Seismic Toss, Nightshade, Soak, Salcure, Leech Seed, etc. All of those. And then you have two pretty advanced strats, I would say. So you have this one from one of the users. It is a Shininja speedrun. So it talks about how to use the different moves and how to put them together. It's very, very fast to read and pretty easy to understand as well. And you have this speedrun guide, which is the one from Dom, I believe. And this one is just a speedrun with Blissey Mech, so Metal Burst and all of that. On how to create those. Those are very simple to follow. So if you are looking for ideas, I guess you can start here with Shininja and for the Blissey Tech. There you go. So this is about Discord. You have a lot of different links. We can actually go back to Discord here. And you have the Hall of Fame, of course, just to read what people are saying, the different teams that are used. There is a lot of teams. You can see what people are using, etc., etc. So Discord is very important. So the wiki is available on this address here, or you can get the link in-game in the link tab. So you have a lot of information about starters, biomes, controls, eggs, and all of that things. I would say most of the time, I am going to be in the biome and mechanic pages. So you have a lot of information on different biomes, so what Pokémon to find in those, etc., etc., where to go or where you can go. You have the map of the biomes at the bottom, so very important, of course. And you have an explanation of the mechanics, so how the luck works with shinies, the different variants of shinies. You have some explanation on there as well. You have the fusion, how it works, how the time works as well, the different candies, abilities, the boss. So all the information about the mechanics, of course. And beyond that, so if you're looking for a move like Salcure, for example, who has it as an egg move, or who has a passive ability of Sturdy, for example, you can tap Sturdy in the research at the top right. And here you have a couple of starters that have Salcure, or sorry, Sturdy as a passive ability. So you're gonna open each one of them. There you go. And they're gonna be highlighted as well. So you can see Squirtle, for example, has Sturdy as a passive ability. So you can unlock that and use that if you want to. Or you have Burmy as well. You need to unlock that. Or you have all the Duck Trio. So you have the Wiglet and you have Alola Diglett as well. So you have those. And if you are looking for, let's say, Salcure, for example, as you can see, we have a couple of them. So we have all of those with starter here. We can just take all of those links and we are going to look for the highlighted one. So Shuckle has it, right? Corsola has it as well. And Smeargle has it. There you go. So you have a lot of Pokemon with it and you don't need to get like Garganacle specifically. You can get the one of those Pokemon as your starters. So this is why and how I'm using the wiki, I would say. It's mostly for like mechanics. When I have a blank on something, I want to go into mechanics. I'm going to go into biomes just to direct myself, even though those days I'm using something different, but I will explain later. And you can just have check the items, how they work, the weight. So you have a lot of information on this wiki and you have all the unlockables. So you have how to unlock Endless, how to unlock Spliced Endless, what we are doing currently. So Beat Classic with a Spliced Pokemon, the Mini Black Hole, how to unlock Eternatus and have him as a starter. Use the wiki. Very important, very good resource, I would say. Next resource is going to be Pokemon.help. This is actually the one I'm using the most with the last one on this list, actually. This is a site to help you with typing overall, I would say. So if you're looking for type coverage, so if you have, let's say, a water, fire, and grass type, this is what you're going to cover overall. So this is what you need to cover. So you need something for dragon. Just for type coverage offensively. Okay, so this is offense. So if you have a fire type, water type, and grass type, offensively, you have those ones covered. So let's say I want to have something for dragon, I can go something with ice. There you go. If I want something to counter, for example, poison, I can take some psychic, etc., etc. And then you have the list of what you're going to be covering. So 72% of the Pokédex is weak to your team. Normal is 27.7% and 0% are gonna be resisting. So you are covering everything at least at a 1x level. Of course, you need some stuff for all of those, or it depends on how you build your team. So this is gonna be for the offense part. For the defense part, it is good to use this. So most people are gonna use it for like a typing chart. For example, if you are looking for the weakness to an ice type, you can just click ice here and you can see that ice is gonna be weak from fighting, rock, steel, and fire. All right, so just a quick look at the typing. If the Pokemon is gonna be, for example, grass and ghost, it's gonna be weak to flying, ghost, fire, ice, and dark. So this is mostly it, I would say, just to check a quick type chart, I would say, for double types. But this is gonna be mainly for teams as well. So you can enter your different Pokemons and save them. So for example here, if I have a water type and no second type, I can just add this one. Then I can add a second Pokemon. So the first one is saved. And I have, let's say I have a fire type now. Okay, add a new one. I have a grass type. There you go. Those are all my Pokemons. Water, fire, grass. I can see what I'm like potentially weak against, my different weakness, and what I resist. So fire and water resist fire, of course. I'm weak against flying, but this is mostly for the grass type. So this is just a matchup count on your team. So this team aspect is gonna be mainly for identifying if you have any kind of weakness against a specific element. For example, let's say I have a, flying type, I have a ground type, and I have a grass type, and a dragon type. I guess you can probably guess what kind of weakness I have. It's gonna be ice, as you can see. If I have some kind of elite four with like ice Pokemons only, or if I have a gym leader in the ice cave, I'm gonna have a very bad issue with ice types overall because those are gonna counter most of my teams. You need a response or a big response for ice specifically. So this set is gonna be definitely for those kinds of find, just for offense, just to see what you have, what you're missing, and for the defensive aspect, what you are weak to and resistant to. I'm gonna have like two tabs open, one for offense for my team and one for defense, just to see at a very quick peek what I'm missing and what I need. So the next link is gonna be the type chart. Most of the time you can use the link before for a quick watch at it, but I like to use this type chart here. It is made by someone named Power Hungry Hippo. Pretty cool name. This looks very overwhelming, I would say, but it's actually pretty easy to read. You have the type attacking you on the left side, and you have the type you're attacking on the right side, and your type. So what does electric do? So if you check electric here, for example, you can see that ground is going to be very effective against electric as an attack. So if you're a ground type and you're attacking into an electric type, you're going to do 2x damage. But if you are an electric and flying and steel type, you're going to do 0.5 against electric. So just to have a quick peek at this, and if you are attacking as an electric type, you're going to do 2 to water and flying, but you're going to do 0.5 to grass, electric, dragon, and 0 to ground. See, it's very easy to read, and when you get used to it, of course. So if you look for, let's say we are looking for, okay, so what grass? What is grass? What is grass weak to? So grass is weak to fire, flying, ice, poison, bug. There you go. Do you have a resistance? Okay, so water, grass, electric, ground does not do any damage to grass. If I attack with grass, I do 2x into water, ground, and rock, and 0.5 into fire, grass, flying, poison, bug, dragon, steel. It's just a very quick peek at what kind of damage you are doing. I would say this is a pretty good type chart, and again, it's going to be available in the description. The next link is going to be about Smogon. So I would say Smogon, I don't really use it too often, but it is a good resource if you're looking for, not nearly for moveset. So of course, this is going to be great for moveset as well. So if you're looking for a moveset for Gengar, for example, you can check here. So most of the time, you're going to have some kind of strats or explanation. If you go into the previous gen, for example, you can have some kind of ideas how to use that. So you have Gmax here. Okay, let's read. What are they saying? What are they saying for the moves? What are the counters? So this is mostly for PvP, of course, right? So it doesn't really have any place in PvE because you don't really have access to those moves anyway. I mean, in this case, you do. You don't really have access to Focus Blast and Substitute, but you can have Shadow Ball and Nasty Plot. For sure. And you can always replace those, right? Or change the format and check what they have. Substitute, Nasty Plot, Shadow Ball, and Dazzling Gleam. Okay, so can you have that or can't you? But that's not really what I'm using Smogon for. I don't really care about those. Most of the time, I can do my own moveset, so that's not the issue. The thing I'm looking for on Smogon is going to be moves. There is different ways to do this, of course, but this is what I'm using Smogon for. Mainly for Pokemons, I would say, for stats. Or just a quick look at a moveset just to have a quick idea. But this is going to be mainly for a move. So if you're looking for a... let's say you're looking for a physical ability that's poison only. You know, so you click on poison. You have all the Pokemons, right? So you have all the poison types. At the very bottom, you have moves. And now you can see which one is going to be a status, which one is going to be special, and which one is going to be a physical attack. So you can see here, okay, we have cross poison. High critical hit ratio, 10% chance to poison. We have, so the G-Max moves don't count, of course. But we have gun shot. Okay, I know about gun shot. Okay, we have poison fang. We have poison jab, poison tail, etc., etc. So I'm looking here. Okay, the best move, gun shot. 120 power, 80% accuracy. This seems like it's gonna be okay. So I click on gun shot. So here, for example, you can see in the latest version, so SV, Arbok actually has Gunkshot. So I knew about Arbok because I was looking into him recently. So if you click on Arbok, here you can see all the moves that he has. But this is going to be mainly for filtering the moves and if I forget about those. So the best steel special type, I'm just going to go into moves. I'm going to look for a steel. Steel, there you go here. And I'm going to go at the bottom and I'm just going to look, okay, so what's the best physical attack for steel what's the best like special attack for steel, etc., etc. So we have Doom Desire, we have Flash Cannon. Okay, so Flash Cannon, it's available, so it's good for SV. Okay, so Arcus has it, Arcaludon has it, etc., etc. So that's what I'm looking for on Smogon and for quick peek at moveset just for IDs as well. So the next link is going to be the Pokerogue Dex. This is from Idarisep Pokédex. You probably know him, I'm assuming. And he has a Pokerogue edition. So he has Radical Red. He has one for Emerald Rogue as well. But he has one for Pokerogue. It's actually pretty recent. So basically, you have all the species, all the abilities, all the moves, and you have locations. And this is for Pokerogue specifically. All right? So for example, if we are looking at a Pokémon, we want to know how he evolves. So let's say, for example, I'm looking into Weavile, for example. Okay, I'm going to look Weavile. Okay, we have him. You click on it and you have a fish of all of its information. So this is a 4-cost, 4-starter cost. This is a Dark Ice. You have all the abilities. So you have Moxie, Pressure, Pickpocket. You have an explanation of it. You have the stats and you have the evolution on Pokerogue. So it evolves at whatever level at night. So if we check here, we can actually click on the evolution and see we have a quick peek. So Sneasel, Weavile, Sneasel, Weavile. And you have everything that updates on the defensive side. So you are weak to fighting, fire, bug, rock, steel and fairy. And offensively, you are strong against grass, ground, fly, psychic, ghost and dragon. And you have all the egg moves. So you have Dire Claw, Cotocleave, Triple Axel, and you have the P as well. If the ability is implanted or not, or the move in this case, Glacial Lance as well as a rare egg moves. So the one at the bottom is going to be the rare egg moves. And you have all the moves that you can learn as a level up. And you have the ones that you can learn as a TM and HM. And you have a lot of information on all of those, right? You can filter as well if you're looking for a specific ability. So who has it? If you click on Dire Claw, for example, you can click on Filter and it's going to show you all the Pokémon that have Dire Claw as an egg move and as a learn move as well. So egg move, learn. So Sneasler has it by default and you have all of those Pokémon that has it as a egg move. All of those Pokémon. If you are looking for a specific ability, let's say we are looking for an ability called Sturdy. Alright, so there you go. Some Pokémon have Sturdy as a passive ability. The passive ability is going to be the one in purple. And the one in white are going to be the normal abilities. So if we click on Isui Avalog here, we can see that he has Sturdy as a... I would say this is probably the hidden ability, right? But the one in purple is going to be the passive ability. So we can see here, Alola Dugtrio has Sturdy as a passive ability. Same example here. Wiglet has Sturdy. Dugtrio has Sturdy. So all of those Pokémon that we saw earlier on the wiki, you can actually see it here as well. So this is just a huge website. This is an insane website, okay? I mean, I was using it before, but there is a Pokerogue edition now, so it's actually pretty good. If you're looking for a move or an ability or whatever, I would say most of the time, you're better off just looking at the top for what you want. Let's say I want a Pokemon with Salcure. I was looking for it earlier. You're going to click on Move, Salcure, and you can see we have all the Pokemon that are going to learn Salcure as an ability, as a move. So we have level 0 for Knuckle Stack on Evolution, basically. Garganacle at level 24. And then we have all of those Pokémon that have it as an egg move. All right. Just a huge website, I would say. And of course, you have the location as well. So we have all the biomes here. Let's say I am currently in the factory, for example. I'm going to type factory. So we are in location right now. You can still look for factory, I think, on the main... Oh, you can't. Okay, good to know. So you have to go into location. I'm looking for factory. Okay, so what do we have in the factory? So in the factory, we have Machop, Machoke, Magnemite, Magneton. So those are going to be common encounters. You have the uncommon ones, the rare ones, super rare, and you have the bosses and the super rare bosses. All right, so again, I would say I spent 95% of my time on this website. This is probably the best one you can use for Pokerogue. Alright, so I wanted to talk to you about the Idarisep Pokédex. I am not sure this is currently very official what he has. It is going to be official in the future, but it is available in the offline app. That's why I was talking about it. He has some GitHub pages for some of his Pokédex. I am not sure if he has one for Pokerogue Currently, I think he's working on it, of course. So what you want to do, if you want to have access to the website that I had earlier, you need to go into his code and you need to clone it and pull it, or you can just zip it. So download the zip here and then you unzip and you just launch the index.html. So I can actually show you how it works. So if you download or clone or whatever is Pokédex, you can just click on the index.html here, add it into your browser, and you are going to import the Pokédex that we just saw earlier. That's what I'm doing currently. I'm cloning and pulling the different updates. In the future, if there is a website, please let me know. There is some commit to it, some changes, added some files, like fixed some incomplete abilities, etc., etc. So it might be a bit incomplete, but I would say this is probably one of the best, like, resource for the game. So feel free to, you know, download the HTML page and just launch it locally. It should work just fine. And finally, this is gonna be the Rockdex extension for Chrome, Firefox, and all of those. Basically, this is made by, well, this was originally made by this guy, Rockdex Dev, or whatever his actual name is. And it is now a community thing for sure. There is a lot of people involved in it. We basically have explanation or information, or in this case, actually information about the current file that you have. So for example, if you are now in a file, I'm gonna actually take this screenshot here. So if you have Eternatus as a Pokemon, that's what you have. So your ability, your nature, what you are weak to, and what you are strong against, etc., etc. And you have the Pokemons over there. So I think the better way to show it to you is to actually go in game and explain to you how this works. All right, so we are currently in game. You can see my screen. We have a Puccina against us. So I have the window. I have the current extension installed right now. You can see I have a Quaxly, but you can actually, so you can zoom. So if you do Control Plus in your browser, it's not gonna increase the zoom on the on like the PokéRog, but it's gonna be increasing the zoom on the actual app. So if you have a big PC or something, you can actually zoom in and you can see even better. So just get this back. So here we have the arrow. So this is my team currently. I have Zacian, Zigzagoon, Bibabel, etc. So you can actually see my team, right? So this is what I have currently. And you can just go on Zacian, for example. So there you go. So Zacian is gonna be weak to those. So it's gonna be weak to poison and steel. And it's gonna be resisting like bug, dark, etc., etc. And I'm gonna be immune to dragon. You can like get the opacity down if you want, if it's too much for you. And of course, at the top here, you can move it as well or move it over here, but you have the move window here. So just be careful about it. I would say the best thing is just to put this on the left side here, just to have a quick peek at it and put this like near the enemy borders with an opacity here. And you can see what Puccina is going to be weak to, resistant to, and immune to. So this is a dark type. So it's going to be weak against all of those here. So fairy, bug, and fighting. And it's going to be resisting to ghost and dark. And it's going to be immune to psychic. This is just how it works, right? And you can, again, lower the opacity. So this is an in-game app that you can use, and they're just giving you information about the ability that he has, potentially the nature that he has, and the different IVs that he has as well. So this is actually pretty good if you're looking for the IVs that he has. So he has 1 in HP, 15 in attack, 4 in defense, 7 in special, 21 in speed, and 14 in special attack. And this is my IV on my Zacian, for example. Right, my nature as well. You can see quickly what kind of IV they have. So this is actually pretty good. If you have a Pokemon with perfect IVs, you can definitely capture it. This is way worth your time. A great tool for maybe information about abilities and IVs for more experienced people. And for people that don't really know about the type charts too well, you can quickly see what you are like weak to on your Pokemon and what kind of move you want to use against the enemy. Again, this app is going to be available in the description. I'm going to post to the actual guy that makes the post, because he's probably going to relink to these different updates. Just install it, follow the tutorial that he has. There is a Firefox extension, I think, and there is a Chrome extension too, but you need to like import it manually for now, of course. And there is one for Opera GX too. So there you go. That's going to be it. We are actually back in the menu. We saw a couple of links. I would say those are pretty important just for Pokemon overall. You're going to use them for Pokemon and every game, but some of them are actually pretty insanely valuable for PokéRock specifically, like the Pokédex that we saw earlier, or the extension for the browser. It's pretty good for beginners, I would say. In this fashion, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like it, and if you are here for the second time, subscribe, that would be pretty cool. If you have any leaks that you are using, please let me know in the comments, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!